Good evening.
Enjoy coming out here because it's always fun. You know, it's always fun. It's always chilled. You get to the border. They don't ask too many questions. I prefer coming to the UK. If I'm to choose between the UK and America, I would choose to come to the UK. I enjoy America more because it's more exciting. Over the last few months, it's been particularly stressful, though. Ever since the Ebola outbreak, that has made life particularly stressful for me going into America because I'm South African, so they deem me to be a high-risk Ebola person because I'm coming from an Ebola region, which is the whole continent, apparently. Yeah, because that's all most people think Africa is. It's just one big hut where we just cough on each other the whole day. That's all we're really doing out there. Just...
Okay, now do me.
One of the worst flights I went on was going out to Los Angeles. And because of the duration of the flight, you have to stop over from South Africa to LA. You have to stop over in Washington. And so we got off the flight and they took us in a little bus to the next flight. And the air hostess on this flight decided to tell the passengers that there were Africans joining the flight. And so because of that, they would be spraying the cabin with a light pesticide, right? Which I don't mind, I understand. When people are afraid, they do stupid things. I didn't understand why she told this to them as we were boarding. We're literally walking onto the plane and she comes on her little microphone and she's like,
"Ladies and gentlemen, please note we have some passengers joining us from a South African flight. And due to the Ebola crisis right now, we're going to be spraying the cabin with a light pesticide. You feel free to cover your eyes, nose, and mouth. It shouldn't be harmful to you. But if it is, you probably want to cover that up anyway. People coming in right now, everybody stay in your seats, and we should be on our way shortly. Thank you very much."
She says this as we're boarding the plane. This is our introduction.
Ebola risk.
That's us now. It was the most tense flight I've ever taken in my life. I coughed once. The plane shook. It wasn't even a bad cough, but clearly there was a man who had been waiting for this. As soon as I let it go, I was like, he was like, "Ebola! Ebola!" I was like, "Yo, dude, calm down. It's just AIDS, man. You're safe for now, buddy." Everyone was stressed. The plane landed. Everyone couldn't wait to get out. We finally get to the gate. As people are about to jump up, the air hostess comes back on. She's like,
"Ladies and gentlemen, get back in your seats. Everybody back in your seats. Unfortunately, we can't disembark just about now. We have a health and safety official coming on board just to make sure everything is A-okay. So please stay in your seats."
And now, because of Ebola, we couldn't leave the plane. We had to sit there and wait while the health and safety official came on board. And he had with him a list of all the African passengers, and he had a laser thermometer. And his job was to go around the plane ticking off names and scanning the passengers. And I think the way it works is, if you're very hot, then you've got Ebola, right? So he walks around, scanning people, ticking names, walks down the plane, gets to where I'm seated, scans some passengers next to me, looks at the list, looks back at me, and then he's like,
"Nah."
And he walks away. Almost as if I wasn't African enough. It was the strangest thing. I've never felt so rejected. More conflicted in my life. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong. I don't ever want to be seen as an Ebola threat. But I also don't want anyone to assume that I can't have Ebola. You don't know me. You don't know what I'm capable of. Don't you dare judge me. I could get any disease I please. If I work hard enough, anything is possible. But he just left me. He just walked away. And so as he gets to the tail end of the plane, he realizes he's now missing a name on the list. And so he's perplexed. He's standing there like, where the hell? He's looking around. He can't figure out what it is. I know it's me. All right, but I'm not going to own up now. I'm not going to give him. He's missed his chance. I'm not going to be like, "Yeah, I'm the threat. No, so I just sit there quietly. He's panicking. The air hostess comes down to him and she's like, "Hey, what's going on? Can we get the people out?" He's like, "Yeah, I got a bit of a problem out here. I can't figure out the Ebola list. I got a name missing." He's like, "Yeah, I got to get people out. I'm dead if I don't get the people out." He's like, "Yeah, look, I mean, this is killing me as well, but I mean, I can't get this." Now, everyone on the plane is starting to stress because they don't even hear what they're saying. They're just hearing keywords. It's like broken telephone. So all the people know is there's an Ebola threat and this guy's at the back going, "Yeah, killing people, dead." And she's like, "Yeah, dead, everybody on the plane, got to get me." So now everyone is stressing out. The guy opposite me, he doesn't even hide it. He's looking at me like, "It's you, Ebola, it's you." I was like, "I do not have Ebola. Shut up. He's like, "It's you." I was like, "Dude, I'll cough on you if you don't shut up. I'll cough on you right now." He's like, "What the hell?" He's like, "I'll kill you." I was like, "I'll kill you first." Everyone is panicking. In the middle of the chaos, a man behind me, right? A Muslim man, very traditional garb, very big beard from Pakistan, one of those regions. He's sitting there and he leans into the chaos. And I'll never forget this till I die. Without a hint of irony whatsoever, he leans over and he says to the air hostess, he goes,
Excuse me, pardon me. Sorry to interrupt, but I couldn't help noticing what you were saying. I thought maybe you want to check that gentleman over there. He was wearing a hoodie, cough, little bit, something suspicious. And something made me uncomfortable when I look at him. Something, maybe you want to check him. I don't know. You know what they say? If you see something, you say something. Eh? I just thought maybe you...
I was like, really? Et tu, Ahmed? How the wheel has turned, my friend. You quickly forget there was a time when Muslims were the black people of the skies. And yet now you've deserted me. I thought he's the one person who'd be on my side, you know? The one person who'd look over and be like, don't worry, brother. I've also been stigmatized. I got your back. Instead, he threw me under the bus, sold me out. Like, hey, it's your turn now. I'm free, bitches. You guys have been fun. Thanks for having me. Goodbye. Still for-